How to use a dev mask to hide the water in your boat or any object. I dragged my boat to the water and it caused water to appear inside the boat. This is how the mesh works. So first I'm using this free noise assets by Maxime Burununi. It can be useful in fantasy, countryside or adventure games. It's wonderful. Found this dev mask shader from the wiki. This shader draws faces that are invisible but which still appear in the dev buffer. This allows you to prevent objects from being drowned where they are occluded by the mask. I use the same boat for the mask. I have made a copy and name it mask boat. Create a shader and paste this code. It won't draw the RGB channels and it will just use the dev buffer. A dev buffer, also known as a Z buffer, is a type of data buffer used in computer graphics to represent depth information of objects in 3D space from a particular perspective. Without a mechanism for managing overlapping surfaces, objects would render on top of each other, and this is where the dev buffer proves invaluable. Create a material from this mask shader and assign it to the mask boat. By adjusting the render queue from 2000 to a higher number, the boat mask disappears, effectively masking the water. However, there might be additional unwanted clipping, and the optimal approach is to use a proper mesh for masking. For instance, for this boat, it's preferable to use a mesh that covers only some areas. In most common scenarios, you will only need a few objects to be masked. If, however, you need more, you might find it useful to attach the setRenderQS script to mask themselves and set their render queue.